And we are back with some more NBA 2K17, the prelude. We're in the bonus game in a big pond. So let's get to it.
Basketball fans, what a night we've got in store for you. The Australians going up against the United States. They are playing for bragging rights on the world stage. What a crazy amount of talent from both countries we have gathered here tonight, folks. We'll see Australia and Team USA.
And what a tournament it's been so far. And we're just getting started. Two great teams going at it with the United States against an up-and-coming Australia.
And, you know, after all the games, it comes down to this. No matter who steps up to win the title, we've been treated to an incredible exhibition of all the best players in the world all tournament long.
Australia will get the first possession.
And on the international stage like this, it is always amazing to see the best and brightest of the United States come together. So many teams represented here today.
And the saying is country before club. And as much as all these stars like to battle it out in the NBA, they all have one goal when playing in the red, white, and blue. An incredible collection of talent for sure, and one mission in mind.
And Patty Mills played his college ball at St. Mary's in California. The fifth Australian player they've successfully recruited. A real pipeline of talent from down under to that school.
Yeah, and his college games were televised live in Australia. Despite the time difference, left after two seasons going 55th back in that 09 draft. And in 2015, they retired his number 13 jersey.
Here's Green. Australia getting their last shot to go. He dishes it to Durant. A 15-footer.
I'm just gonna simulate to when I play this game. Alright, so we're in the lead. We just gotta keep the lead.
Feeds to Bain. The pass to Exum. Just 5 to shoot. Now the dish to Dellavedova. And another miss by Australia.
And this tournament has shown the world just how far Australian basketball has come. A lot of great players on this team, and almost all of them playing for NBA teams.
Well, over the past few decades, basketball has really exploded in Australia. And they're seeing what could be the start of a golden era for their national team. And what an honor it has to be for Prez to be representing his country on perhaps one of the biggest stages of basketball. Prez showed what he's capable of in college, and with his skill set, it wasn't too surprising to see him named to the team.
All right, we made our first
free
throw.
It's been an incredible learning experience for Prez.
Well, it's been a bit of a tradition to take one exceptional college player on the U.S. team and on their roster. This cycle, it's Prez's turn.
And it's happened before. Remember Christian Leitner and the Brow, and just how those two were special in college. The same can be said for Prez. Plus, he'll get a chance to test himself on the international stage.
And, you know, Prez isn't a guy who's just demanding of himself, but he's also demanding of his teammates, too.
With Prez and being named to this team, USA Basketball will traditionally call in one standout college player to fill out the roster. Prez was that guy for this tournament.
Well, he was a standout in college, and you know about how high expectations are for Prez at the next level. He's been getting a taste of basketball at the highest level in this tournament. It just has to be an honor for him to be able to be a part of Team USA.
Right side, George. And Butler gets it to go on the assist by George.
And it's like raining buckets right now.
That good ball movement, right?
Well, we got to be careful. Don't want to get ahead of ourselves just yet. But it has been pretty ugly.
End of the first.
And a double-digit lead on the scoreboard as we end the first quarter of play. Team USA leading by 10. After this break, we'll be back with the start of the second quarter on 2K Sports. Everyone, international basketball at its finest. Already one quarter in the books. USA versus Australia. A lot of talent on both of these teams.
And guys, this USA squad looks pumped and really ready to go. They've got to be feeling pretty good about how they've been playing.
No doubt about that. I mean, but this Australian team is extremely talented. And there's plenty of time left. So it'll be interesting to see how the Boomers execute here in the second quarter.
Well, when the U.S. picks players from the NBA,
give me an assist. Give me an assist. There we go.
Then that to assemble the best team that they can.
Yeah, and that's a great point, because this is not an all-star team, although many of these players are all-stars. There's a difference. Really, they're looking for players that can impact the game without the ball, make others around them better, and are suited for the international style of play.
And some changes here for Australia. Cameron Bairstow comes in for Anderson, and Martin subbed in for Exum.
And what can you say about the impact of Coach K?
That was funny. That was funny.
More importantly, though, it has brought the prestige
back
to the program. The best of the best in the U.S.
came right back.
Again, line up to be a
it was funny, but sad at the same time. It was all bad.
Australia trails by 12. Now here is Dellavedova. Defended by Butler. Australia needs to get off a shot here. And it's Dellavedova missing. And with Coach K, that is what I think people forget. USA Basketball was underachieving in tournaments before he took over in 2006.
Yeah, exactly, Kevin. I mean, Coach K was the perfect guy to ignite a real passion for players to get excited about representing their country again. I mean, had the gravitas with all the pros because of his legendary status as a college coach, knows how to manage people and players and these stars. And he's had them playing unselfishly and as a unit his entire tenure. Credit to Coach K for sure, but also to the players as well.
That's not even who I wanted to shoot. I didn't want to pass it to that person. I'm trying to pass it to somebody else.
Yep, exactly. I mean, the Australians put together a team that works extremely well with each other and have played unselfish basketball the whole way. I mean, they're definitely more than the sum of their parts on paper. I'd say kudos to the Australians.
Got 2 points in the foul.
This group together.
Those defenders just look a little bit gassed. I mean, they're getting pushed around on that low block.
Alright, we've been subbed out. I'm gonna skip to when I'm in. Well, there's halftime. We're still in the lead. Third quarter, 4:26 left. Okay. We're still up, by 9.
Hills with it, and it takes him in the corner. And another miss by Australia.
Hey guys, this is something that happens at every international gathering. It's fun to see so many of the U.S. and Australian players going head to head, even though they're on the same NBA team.
Yeah, and they played against each other before in practice, but in competition, where a title is on the line, you better believe it would be a no-holds-barred affair. You know, Patty Mills is the go-to scorer for this Australian team. Back in 2012 in London, he was the leading overall scorer for any country.
Here's Prez.
All right, there we go. We did something that's semi-impressive.
DeAndre Jordan's checked in for Cousins. Carmelo Anthony comes in for Draymond Green. George has checked in for Kevin Durant. And it's Butler in for Kyrie Irving. And he sinks the second.
Alright, let's see if we can keep our B minus or go above that.
Here's Prez. Pass to George, and there's the 3 second violation. Australia making a switch here. Bairstow's checked in.
Australia trails by 14. 1:49 left in the third quarter of the game. This is a nice ball movement by Australia. Right wing. Back to Delavidova. Just 5 on the clock. The 3 doesn't get it to drop for him. Some solid defense from Fred.
And a big lead for them on both the scoreboard and the backboard thus far.
Yeah, rebounding has been a big key in this one, Greg. They've asserted their will and have taken control on the glass.
And another miss by Australia.
Boy, there was no hand in his face right there. I thought for sure he was going to knock that down.
That one, I thought that one would go in.
Seconds left in the third. Defended by Butler. Kicks to Delavidova. Shoots a 3. It's hauled in by Team USA.
And the shots just continue to say no in terms of falling.
Here's Prez. And the layup's good off the glass. Prez has got 6 points.
The plan of attack is obvious. Get the ball inside and go strong to the rim.
And, Greg, you know, the defense has been very slow to adapt. I mean, that's 10 straight points now inside.
Delavidova dishes to Baines. Can't cash in from a high post.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that.
That's awesome. That was awesome. Alley-oop, and it was it.
Team USA ahead. They finish off the third quarter on a 10-1 run. We're going to step aside for just a second, but join us right back here for the start of the fourth quarter. And if you're just tuning in, we've got the USA and Australia teams on the floor and ready to get going here for quarter number 4. Team USA leading by 18. Big group substitution here for Team USA. DeAndre Jordan's checked in for Cousins. Carmelo Anthony comes in for George. Franz has checked in for Butler. And it's Kyle Lowry in for Kyrie Irving. There's a good screen. The feed now to Mills. Inside. Got a piece of it. Down low. Bogut the pass to Mills. And another miss by Australia.
Kevin, he's missing shot after shot after shot from long range. The time running low, he'd be better off trying something else.
Prez kicks to Lowry. And it's sent back by Bogut. 5 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Dishes it to Mills. He feeds it to Ingles. He kicks to Delavidova. Shoots. The good-looking shot from the wing.
Oh, man.
And it's Team USA with the ball. Lowry. So it's Team USA winning this one.
Hey, that works for me. It works for me. What was that? C plus? C plus is better than C.
This sort of dominance, particularly here at home. It's a great feeling when you play almost a perfect game and to have that crowd be so pumped up.
And that'll wrap it up, folks.
Well, that was quite an interesting game. Well, that's that for the prelude. Now we wait until the 16th. That's only 3 days away. 3 days away. I already got my pre-order in. Yep. Just check me out on the 16th. We'll have first official episode up. Yeah. See what happens next. Well, I'm DJ B-Love from Project Bubblegum. If you like what you saw, hit that like button. If you got any comments, questions, or suggestions, feel free to leave them in the comment section below. You know, and until next time, y'all. Peace.